Hello and welcome back to another video with Itsdrdan, and today we're going to be learning how to memorize the polyatomics. Now, the polyatomic ions, the best way to memorize them is sometimes just simply use flashcards, but sometimes we don't have the luxury of being able to remember all of them. I'm going to teach you today the T43 method, which is something that you can easily be able to find just by having a periodic table, which is generally the only thing you are allowed to have on a lot of Chem 3A or Chem 1A or any or whatever level of chemistry exams. So let's get into it. So the whole idea here is, what exactly are the polyatomics? Well, these are your oxyanions, meaning they are all these different species where there's a nonmetal that's bound to multiple oxygens. Now, these different species, they always exist in the exact same unit, meaning that this, let's say if I have this CO3 here, it's always going to be bound together, and it's all, the entire thing has a 2 minus charge. So every single time it has the same charge, same number of oxygens, and we treat it like an anion. Now, the easy way to try to do these is, first is I recommend just memorizing the 8 ions, which are the ones that have the most number of oxygens for the majority of the polyatomics. Now, flashcards do help with trying to memorize these, but it's easy to forget, and sometimes you get stressed and anxious and you don't remember. But there's a hidden trend in your periodic table for this method. Now, I did not come up with this method. It's one that I kind of picked up from my students finding things on YouTube, and it is very, very helpful if you are confident in it. So let me show you where it is. So it all starts with looking at the periodic table right here. So what we have here is we can actually spell out the letters T, 4, and 3 when you look at this. So we see a T, 4, 3. And what the whole idea here is, by spelling this out in this exact pattern, it tells you the number of oxygens for each of these species. So what we're going to do here is, on the next part, we're going to look at each one of these. We're going to analyze them and assign exactly how we can memorize this, so that way we can remember it very quickly and on the fly, so that way you're quicker on an exam. You don't want to be bogged down. You want to know it fast. Now, every single teacher is a little bit different. Sometimes they will give you reference sheets to know your polyatomics, maybe on the first exam or the second one. But most of them, especially if you're taking chem, depending on your level of chemistry, they will eventually expect you to know them by the end of the semester. And definitely if you are a science major who has to take harder courses, you will need to know this. For health science majors, typically you need to know this because the polyatomics are something that is very prevalent in a lot of health science applications, such as in medicines, or maybe something that's like used in different plastics or casts or all kinds of different things that you find laying around, and even in a lot of your food and nutrition items as well. It's all around us. So let's take a look at this method. All right, so I recopied our T43 from our periodic table, and I put down all the elements that are here that make up those, and I color-coded them to match. Now, the key here is what the T43 represents is the number of oxygens that each one of these different species present or have. So if you have T, that means that you have 3. If you have the number 4, that means 4. And then the number 3 means 3. So what we're going to do here is we're going to fill in all these little missing pieces. So we'll start over here on the chlorates and bromates and iodates. And we will fill in all the charges. When we go over to sulfate and selenite and tellurite, you can see that we also have all of our individual pieces as well. So same with like phosphate and arsenate. Then with nitrate, we can see that we have 3. Same with carbonate, siliconate, and borate. We have each one of those that matches the number that we have. Now, what about the charges? The good thing is here is the charges actually, for the most part, go with the periodic table trends. So if you remember, for the halogens, right, that's -1, for sulfur, that's -2. So we can fill in the same charges for those columns. So we're going to put the negative one next to the chlorates, bromates, negative two next to the sulfates and selenates and tellurates. Now, with nitrate and below, this is where it's a little different. So phosphate and arsenate are still 3-. They go off the rule, but things kind of like reset on the T area, which I realize this is miscolored here. So on T, we kind of reset our trend. So nitrate is -1, carbonate is -2, and then borate is -3. So it sort of goes backwards in order as we're going through these different trends, okay? So this is how you can quickly be able to memorize them. It goes off your periodic table trends or ion charges. And you can use a T43 to quickly be able to know how many ionic charges. And I hope that this video helped. Please hit that like and subscribe button if it did. I hope that this will help you be able to better understand how to memorize different polyatomic ions. And please check out my other chemistry videos to better further your understanding of chemistry. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.